Hello everyone, and in this lecture we are going to deal with the clinicals of the scalp. In the previous three lectures we have already discussed the arterial supply, nerve supply, the venous drainage, and the introduction of the scalp. There are five layers of the scalp, which were as skin, connective tissue, aponeurosis, loose areolar tissue, and the last one, that is pericranium. Now in this video we are going to cover the clinical aspects of the scalp, wherein we have seven clinicals. The first one to be begin with is the surgical layer of the scalp. So here, surgical layers of the scalp, the first three layers are skin, connective tissue, and aponeurosis, right? So these are the surgical layers of scalp, of the scalp or the scalp proper. All these three layers are firmly adherent to each other and cannot be separated. So I hope you understand what is it. So this is keynote. Hairs caught up in machinery and the scalp proper is avulsed, and these three layers cannot be separated. So agar ye hairs hamare machinery mein aa jate hain, to jo scalp proper hai wo avulsed ho jata hai, and then we have to heal it. So the surgical layers of the scalp are the first three layers, that is skin, connective tissue, and aponeurosis, which are the scalp proper, and they cannot be separated with each other. Now the dangerous layer or dangerous area of the scalp, that is the second clinical of the today's lecture. The second clinical dangerous area, the fourth layer of the scalp, is called the dangerous area of the scalp, right? So the loose areolar connective tissue is the dangerous area. Here what happens is the blood or pus is collected during the scalp injury, and infection may travel through emissary vein into the intra-DVS, that is dural venous sinus, और ब्रेन causes thrombosis which may be fatal. So क्या होता है, जो फोर्थ लेयर है, दैट लेयर हैज़ ब्लड एंड पस टू बी कलेक्टेड इन दैट लेयर, एंड ड्यूरिंग द इंजरी द पस एंड ब्लड इज कलेक्टेड इन दिस लेयर, एंड थ्रू द एमिशरी वेन दैट इज देयर इन द फोर्थ लेयर, इट ट्रेवल्स टू द इंटरनल इंटरनल और इंट्रा ड्यूरल वीनस साइनस और विच इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन, एंड कॉजेज थ्रोम्बोसिस ओवर देयर, और ये जो थ्रोम्बोसिस हो जाता है उसकी वजह से डेथ भी हो सकती है. देयरफॉर इट इज़ फैटल. यू कैन हियर सी द ब्लड इज कलेक्टेड इन द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू ओवर द ऑर्बिकुलरिस ओरिस. दिस इज अवर नेक्स्ट थीम, दैट इज द ब्लैक आई. नाउ व्हाट हैपन्स इज द लूज एरियोलर टिश्यू, दैट इज सॉरी द लूज एरियोलर टिश्यू दैट इज द फोर्थ लेयर ऑफ दिस स्कैल्प, एक्सटेंड anteriorly into the eyelids, as occipitofrontalis muscle has no bony attachment on the anterior side. So now when we studied the five layers of the scalp in the first lecture, I've already told you the extent of the fourth layer is in the anterior part, it is up to the eyelids, because the occipitofrontalis muscle has no bony attachment. So what happens is blood, which is already accumulated in the fourth layer during the injury, does not have any anterior body attachment, and therefore the blood slips into the eyelids. As we can see, this is the eyelid and blood is slipping down into the eyelids. So this is the blood which is slipping down into the eyelids, and this is causing it. So this leads to formation of hematoma a few hours after the injury, causing the black discoloration of the skin around the eye, and that is known as the black eye. So due to this injury here, the eye becomes black in color. I'll show you in the next thing. So here the eye becomes black, right? First it is reddish and it turns to brown, and then it becomes black. So the causes of the black eye mainly are the local violence, such as fist fighting, causing the subcutaneous extravasation of the blood into the eyelids, right? Now the fourth part is the cephal hematoma. The blood collection in the layers of the skull is known as cephal hematoma. Hematoma matlab blood ka, toma means mass, that is collection, and in the cephalic region, in the region of the skull, that is cephal hematoma. Because of pericranium is adhering to the sutures, collection of blood deep to the pericranium is called as cephal hematoma. Takes the shape of the bone covered where the fracture is there, and there is a part of the पर्टिकुलर बोन जहाँ पे फ्रैक्चर होता है उसका शेप ले लेता है. सो बेसिकली यू हैव टू जस्ट रिमेंबर द कलेक्शन ऑफ ब्लड इन टू द लेयर्स ऑफ द स्कल इज सीफेल हीमेटोमा. नाउ देयर इज सेबेशियस सीट्स, ये ऐसा आएगा, सॉरी सेबेशियस सिस्ट, तो ये जो सिस्ट होता है सेबेशियस सिस्ट वो कैसे बनता है, जो हमारे सेबेशियस ग्लैंड्स बहुत होते हैं स्कल में स्कैल्प में सॉरी एंड दैट इज़ द कॉमन साइन ऑफ साइट फॉर सेबेशियस सिस्ट, जैसे कि ये डायग्राम में दिख रहा है कि यहाँ पे जैसे ये सारे हेयर्स हैं, यहाँ पे ये जो साइट है ये साइट है ये साइट है, यहाँ पे हेयर नहीं है, तो जो हेयर नहीं है जहाँ पे थोड़ा सा रेडिश हो गया एरिया, सो दैट आर सिस्ट दैट आर फॉर्मिंग इन द स्कैल्प, दैट इज़ नोन एज सेबेशियस सिस्ट और बायलैटरल सेबेशियस सिस्ट. Now the sixth one is scapute succedaneum. So what is it? Generalized swelling of the scalp. Subcutaneous edema hota hai over the head at the time of delivery. Now as we know when delivery occurs, the skull is the part or the face is the part or the head is the part that comes first when the baby is delivered. So during that time some injury is there on the head and that causes swelling. So this generalized swelling of the scalp over the head during the delivery is called as scapute succedaneum. This takes place during the passage of the head through the birth canal due to interface of venous return. And most common form of birth trauma of the scalp, affected parts of the scalp are felt soft and the margins are partly defined, right? So the last one is the cepheal hydrocele, that is the CSF collection in the subaponeurotic space. So that's all for this lecture and these are the clinicals done, and the emissary vein is another thing that is left which is of utmost importance, so that will also be covered in the lecture. Apart from that, the scalp is completed, so do watch all the lectures of the scalp, and whatever doubts you have can be solved out. Please comment your doubts in the comment section, and if you like our video please like, subscribe and share the video with your friends, which would help me to gain a lot of confidence and make more such videos for you. Thank you and keep watching All India Medicos.